Blessed and happy Thursday to all of you, my dear friends, my dear brothers and sisters, my dear good people of God, faithful followers of the Daily Gospel Reflection with Father Jack, my dear kababayans. Today is May 16, 2024, Thursday within the seventh week of Easter Year B. Today's Gospel is from the beautiful and the wonderful account of the Gospel of John, chapter 17, verses 20 to 26. Our Gospel for today speaks about the prayer of Jesus. The prayer of Jesus to his disciples. And as a starting point of my reflection, it's good to ask ourselves this question: how do you pray? What's the content of your prayer? What can we learn in today's gospel? First, when we pray, let others be our priority. Pray for others first before praying for ourselves, remembering the other firsts before remembering our own needs. Jesus prayed for his disciples. My dear friends, brothers and sisters, there is power in saying people's name before the Lord. And personally, it is really touching in saying, it is really touching and beautiful when someone prays for you without you knowing it, right? It's the highest form of care. It's the highest form of respect and thoughtfulness. Nothing proves that you love someone more than including or mentioning them in your private prayers. What's my point? If we develop a habit of praying to God for others, we will never need to pray for our own self. What I'm trying to say is this: when you are healthy, when you're safe, when you're happy, when you are in good shape, remember that someone is praying for you. And I am blessed every day because I know someone is wasting time praying for me. I am blessed every day because I know people like you are remembering me in your prayers. When we pray for others, something supernatural takes place. When we pray for others, others will be blessed. Others will be protected from any danger and harm. And the final point that I would like to share today is this: Jesus prayed for unity, not only once, not only twice, but thrice. And the phrase in today's gospel mentioned three times, that they may be one, that they may become completely one, so that they may be one. You know, my dear friends, we live in a world full of divisions. There are divisions everywhere. Our lives were fragmented by division. That's why in a moment like this, the gospel calls us to unite, that we may be one. Why is it important? Why unity is important? Because unity is power. Unity is strength. Division destroys community. Division destroys relationship. Division is like a cancer. That's why oneness is not evading diversities. Oneness is all about love. Love is the binding force of our life. There will be no hatred, there will be no dissension, there will be no opposition in a world governed by love. My dear friends, let us all unite in love. And let me end my reflection by saying the response of our responsorial psalm for today, which says, "Keep us safe, O God, you are our hope." Thank you for all your prayers, and we continue to remember each other in our private prayers. If you love and like this reflection, kindly share it with your friends, share it with your family, make the word of God viral so that many will be blessed. Amen.